assume you didn't mean it like that? Or should I assume you know exactly how you said it? You know exactly how you meant it? Should I assume it's me? Sweet disposition, switching position, ducking submission. Should I assume it's a weekend thing, boy?
Thanks for tuning in to Nizzy's Playhouse, y'all. So I'm gonna jump right in and show you how I got this SZA look for under $20. I'm showing you all the materials that I used here, and nothing cost me over $20. So here I'm showing you, this is the braiding hair. I left it just, you know, folded in half, because if I would have cut it, it would have been really short, and that's not the look we're going for. So for here, I'm just feathering it out, just pulling out random strands so it looks like this at the ends. And make sure you cut all those dead ends off, like that little stuff right there. Just chop it on off, girl. Now go ahead and section your bangs off. I know it looks really weird, like you can see through it, but I have a brown wig cap on, and I'm not gonna be wearing that in the end result look. So here, yep, go ahead and separate your sections. I already went ahead and put the ponytail, the high pony, up there. Go ahead and just brush the kinks out section by section. Just go ahead and get all the tangles out, because we're getting ready to roll this bug up. Now for this part, I'm doing just a flat roll. I'm not twisting the hair. I'm just starting from the bottom. Now we here. And I'm just, and you see it's taking a long time because it is super long. But yep, that's it. And I didn't go all the way up to the top because that's not the look that I was going for. But also make sure, I did the ponytail in two, but I recommend splitting it in four. And then I also recommend to not curl the bangs, because I had to go in and flat iron the bangs. For this method, I did the hot water boiling method. I'll leave the video below on how I do it above. And I just dunked it in the hot water, and now I'm just taking it out and showing you those beautiful coils on the end. Aren't they pretty? It came out exactly as I wanted it to. Now I'm gonna just do the makeup look. This is really self-explanatory, so I'm not gonna go into too much detail. Just sit back and enjoy this ride. It's woke up, baby. Now for this part, I am using lip gloss on my lids because SZA has that glossy lid look. So I'm just using just a little average dollar store lip gloss for my lids.
It's woke up, baby. Thank you.
So I am going in with my ABH palette in a lighter concealer color, because SZA does have that bright under eye look. So I just went in with a lighter color on top of that to intensify my concealer. And then I went in and just carved out some contour on there. Now SZA has some huge lips and I don't have like any at all. So I had to draw my lip line like outside of my line and like go way outside of the box for this look. But it turned out really cute. Going in with my eyebrow pencil to finish the look off with some freckles. All right, y'all. Thanks for watching.